Here's check on stories we're following for you on Robinhood Radio. Well, several Republican legislatures are now standing in opposition to a proposal that could potentially alter existing state laws regarding local racing rules. State Representatives Kurt Vail of Stafford, Rick Hayes of Putnam, Kathleen McCarthy of Waterford, and State Senator Craig Miner of Litchfield expressed issues with unintended consequences of the newly proposed bill HB 6591 because it seeks to regulate the times during which motor vehicle racing can take place. Representative Vail explained that throughout his life he's regularly attended events at local racetracks and noted that the legislation was proposed by Maria Horn of Salisbury, a freshman Democratic state representative from the state's northwest corner. Quoting here, the legislation proposed by Representative Horn seems to create a zoning commission's right to regulate time and operation for vehicle racing, end quote, said Miner. She and I have not spoken about her legislative proposal. I hear it has far-reaching effects across the state, and I do worry that what she has requested may cause larger problems than she may have considered, end quote. So we'll have to see what happens in the state capitol. In addition to this information, Maria Horn has now agreed to meet with people at the Falls Village Firehouse on Route 7 on Thursday, February 7th at 6:30. This will be an informal discussion with Maria about the topic of Lime Rock Park, and it is open to all. I'll remind you, the Norfolk Curling Club has a bond spiel going on. It's called Build Spiel. It'll be held through Sunday, February 2nd at the Norfolk Curling Club on Golf Drive in Norfolk, Connecticut. Now, this is open to spectators absolutely for free. There's 20 teams participating. A You and Me paint party will be held to benefit the junior class. That happens tonight at 6 p.m. at Weebatok High School. It's $35 for an adult child couple. There's limited seating. You can reserve a seat by emailing denise.clapper@weebatok.org. Seats are not guaranteed without a reservation. The theme of the painting is Valentine's. Children should be over five to participate. Beekeeper School will take place February 2nd from 9 a.m. till 3:30 at the Housatonic Valley Regional High School on Warren Turnpike Road. Topics include beekeeping terminology and basic equipment, how to hive a package of bees, colony management in all seasons, and honey production and processing. The fee is $50. To register, visit ctbees.org/bee-school. The Hotchkiss Library of Sharon presents Take Your Child to Library Day on Saturday from 10 till 12. It's a celebration of children and the library. The Hotchkiss Library offering a rotating half-hour story hours from 10 until noon. You could stop by for juice and snacks, a coloring craft, and stay for a take or two of the tales from your favorite picture books, old and new. All ages are welcome. Children are encouraged to register for a library card and check out some books of their own. More information is available at 860-364-5041 or hotchkisslibrary.org. Now you can join the Northeast Millerton Library and the Weebatok Teachers Association on Saturday for their 6th annual Take Your Child to Library Day. Jackie the Magician will be performing through 1:30 to 2:30 in the main library at 75 Main Street. The Weebatok Teachers Association Social Justice Committee is holding its 3rd annual Toys and Clothes giveaway at the Annex at 28 Century Boulevard. The Great Barrington Rudolph Steiner School will host Education, There Is an Alternative, at 3 p.m. on Saturday, February 2nd. In neighboring Columbia County, this event will be held at the Hudson Area Library at 51 North Street. For more information, 413-528-4015, extension 106. Berkshire Botanical Garden presenting an afternoon lecture, The Planted Garden, hosted by gardener Arnie Maynard on Saturday at the Lenox Memorial Middle and High School, Duffin Theater on East Street in Lenox. Pre-registration is required. However, walk-ins will be welcome. For more information, on the web, berkshirebotanical.org. The Salisbury Association Historical Society and Scoville Library are hosting the Connecticut 169 Club, your passport and guide to exploring Connecticut, presented by author and historian Marty Potscotch on Saturday at 4 p.m. at 10 Upper Main Street. The new travel book encourages travelers to visit all towns and villages in the state. He enlisted individuals from each municipality to write a short description highlighting their community's location, history, and interesting places to visit. The guide contains hundreds of photos and maps, serving as a resource for touring the entire Nutmeg State. American Legion Post 178 will host its monthly pancake breakfast. That happens on Sunday from 7 to 11 a.m. at the post located at 155 Route 44. The menu includes pancakes, French toast, syrup, sausage, bacon, eggs, home fries, toast, coffee, hot chocolate, and tea. You can eat in or take out. There is a price of $8 for adults, $6 for children, free two and under. Also on Sunday, it's the brunch at the Interlaken, a benefit brunch to benefit women's support services. It's this Sunday at the Interlaken. The buffet menu includes waffles, made-to-order omelets, sliced ham, bacon, sausage, spinach quiche, muffins, juice, coffee, and tea. The cost, $19.95 for adults, $10 for children 10 and under, and children under 4 free. The Interlaken will donate $500 to Women's Support Services. For reservations and more information, 860-435-9878. Our business brief is underwritten by Morgan's at the Interlaken, interlakenin.com, and by Salisbury Bank, salisburybank.com. The Dow Jones Industrial Average was down 15.19 to 24,999.67. NASDAQ starts off today at 7281.74 and the S&P 500, 2704.10. We'll take a look at the tri-state forecast. That'll come your way in just a few moments.